What is going on, YouTube? Coming at you with my first ever gaming video. Brand new channel. I created it out of nowhere. I have another channel, not kid friendly. Just another hobby of mine. But I want to capitalize on something that I enjoy doing, and that is video gaming. I have a custom PC. I have, you know, my brother who plays with me, and you'll probably see him on here from time to time. And we might do some like Minecraft or something like that. But I just want to do a video, my first one, and hopefully you guys enjoy it. Probably going to be a long one. For any of you that know Warcraft 3 and tower defense games, they can be quite a bit time consuming. And they do have role playing games where you got to build a base, build an army, go attack other people, or do sheep tag or anything like that. But for today, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take you through one of my favorite maps. Now, there's a bunch of TDs, and it looks like they have one, but this Delta TD, that map sucks ass. So, Burbenog TD is my favorite TD, but there's 100 different versions of the same thing, and certain ones are better than others. Certain ones are easier than others. I'm going to actually take you through one of the easy ones, just so you guys get an idea of what I'm like. Rise of the Fallen X is the easiest version of Burbenog TD that I have found. All of the heroes, all of the races are evened out. Hit points and all that are evened out. Now, there are some people that still do not know. As you can see, there's a bunch of Burbenog different ones. But this is the easiest one, and there are still some people that do not know how to play this. So, my gamer tag, DeadCowboy08, if you play this game, add me as a friend on your friends list. I do not care. And yeah, this is just going to be a first ever gaming video, if I can get a full lobby. If not, then I'm going to have to leave and then go join a different game that I don't want to play. So, hopefully I can get a full lobby. And, yeah, so. Now, if you YouTube me, DeadCowboy08, you're going to see my other channel. Created off of, it started as a gaming channel, but nobody ever watched my videos. So, it's doing my other hobby. And for those of you who watch it, who are allowed to watch them, that's what I do. And I do have a full-time job. I do that on my spare time. I do this on my spare time. And I ride motorcycles and all that good stuff. So I don't have a bot, so I can't open and close these slots automatically. I'm a little bit slow when it comes to this stuff. I can't afford a bot. Don't really care about bots. My brother has a bunch of them. I don't. So, nobody wants to play. It's because there's another Burbenog in the lobby, and nobody wants to play. There's not enough people that want to play this. And honestly, Delta Force sucks. For those of you who play it, you know, I'd like for you guys to show me how to play it, because it seems like there's certain races that overpower the other ones, and if you don't know which ones those are, you're gonna have a really hard time, especially if it's not shared income. You're going to have a hard time. Certain races just don't do well against the monsters and creeps. And other ones are like all over it. So, and that's where I kind of like this one, where every round is blitz. Supposedly you get more gold per kill, and yeah, so there's new races in this one. A lot of the same races as what's there, but you got more options. So, I figured more people would be on here seeing how it's Thanksgiving tomorrow. You know, most people are probably at work. I'm off of work due to COVID. I was exposed to somebody who tested positive for COVID, so I'm off being monitored. Had my COVID test yesterday. Should get results. I'm hoping by Friday so I can go back to work this weekend. But, yeah, COVID sucks. And I'm bored out of my mind. So, see if this guy stays. So, for those of you who do not know what Burbenog TD is, so basically you got four corners to the map, four players, you got a spawn point right here at each, they're triggered right off the edge of the map, they go down, and so yours will start here, they go down and around, and around, and around, you know, and before they come back to you, they turn here and they go to the center of the map and they take away your lives. So, it's a pretty easy game. One more. That's all we need. One more. There we go. And I don't really look like your typical gamer, but I enjoy this game very much. So right now everybody has a chance to either pick a random race or vote for the hard difficulty. Most likely it's going to be hard. Everyone's going easy. So yeah, you only get 30 gold at the beginning to build your first couple towers. Everybody gets to pick a race and build. Blue's not doing anything. So yeah. So basically your spawn is going to come out of here and they're going to go down and around the map. And your goal is to kill them before they get very far. And every creep has the ability to come around the map. So here you got your basic towers. In order for me to build these, I have to build this tower. And certain ones of these I can't build with this builder. I have to get a different builder and have the highest power in order to be able to build those. So this is a pretty simple game. So sit back, enjoy. And watch as I take the leaderboard right up here. And I play this a lot.
Job's done. Job's done.
I just noticed we got hard difficulty. Meaning we can only leak one. And people get mad at me in this game because I steal all the kills. This is my favorite race. Not to say I can't play on other races, but this one just seems to mesh with me better. They're all decent if you know how to play them. Especially Magic. Magic is pretty good, so. And I'm gonna get a Magic Builder here soon too, so. I'm gonna sit back, collect some gold, and let my towers do the work for me. And Blue left the game because I'm not reaping enough for him. And that's perfectly fine. I've easily got second place by 100 kills, so I am not too concerned. There we go, got them all. So after every 5 rounds you get a piece of lumber. That lumber you can either use it to build your next tier tower to build these, or to build your ultimate, or you can go here and you get to select a different builder to build different tower styles. See how I can build these now. And this right here, this Inferno, is probably the best tower in the game. For me, anyway. If we don't die on this air round, holy shit. I had 3 people that don't know what they're doing. I have no clue. So, Inferno, they're slow attack rate, but they do high splash, high range. You got your Forgotten One. They're kind of your mid-range tower. They throw little spikes out here on the ground. They do a very, pretty good job. And then your Ultimate, your Dimensional Gate. Best tower in here. I'll get like 4 or 5 of those here later. And then this one's also good to Warlord. It stomps the ground and stuns them all and stops them. hate things that remind me of little dogs' tails. It's kind of funny. Still on top. 474 kills so far. Pretty soon, it's not going to know how many kills I get because I kill them so fast. It'll just give me free kills, you know, every round. It'll say, for the uncounted kills, we'll give you this money.
Job's done.
I don't know why everyone builds their main tower in the path that you can build towers. I built mine over here. It doesn't do anything. Level 10, I'll get another piece of wood, and I'll use that to get a magic builder so I can get my invisible tower, because level 17 is invisible. So, and they're one of the only races that has invisible on the first level, first tier level that you can build without upgrading. None of these towers are upgradable. So the only way to upgrade would be to sell one and put a new tower there, so. I don't do that. I don't really need that many towers in this game to win. And I'm not really... Got a bunch of noobs.
Jesus, it better be worth it. Well?
You know what, I don't mind helping the newer players either on here. We're a team, we can only win as a team, so. So these two eyeball thingies, those are my invisible towers.
What is it now?
I have plenty of time before I even need them, but they do contribute for air and stuff like that in these early rounds. So there's 42 rounds. I'm only on round 11.
Job's done.
Let's spread the love a little bit. Level 17 is immune, or not immune, but invisible. Round 14. I'm good. I don't think Red has any towers for that. No, they don't. So Red's gonna be speed on invisible. I might give everybody a inferno here in a minute. And kind of share the love a little bit. Give everybody an equal chance, so. I don't think Red is building at all. I think they're just sitting. Well, I tried. I'm not just going to go over there and randomly build them a tower. Magic is strong. He's doing just fine. He just has a hard time on immune. Because magic can't hurt its own kind. And, so they're spell immune. And you can see on the map, he does have a tower that can see the invisible. They disappear and then reappear in range of these. So we're going to start saving you guys for this dimensional gate. This is the highest tower I can build with this race. So, I just got a wood. Oh, I got one wood, so I can build that if I have enough gold. Interesting.
Get on with it.
Job's done.
I'm going to actually build one of these. I'm going to have to build one of those anyway, so. Here's the siege, they're going to attack. Red's going to get destroyed. And Red did really good. Well, I kind of do the same pattern every game. I put my dimensionals right here. I usually have 4 of them. These 2 towers right now are stomping and kind of paralyzing them for a minute. It's called scaring them, but they're paralyzing them. Oh, I spent my lumber building this. Never mind. I should get one after this round anyway, so.
Job's done.
Cleaning up. These towers aren't even doing nothing. Help him out a little bit. Help him catch up, build more towers, do whatever he wants with it.
Job's done. Job's done. Thank you.
can hardly wait.
He's catching up. I'm at 1677, he's at 1537.
Job's done.
Purple isn't as new as I thought, but red. Red. I don't know what the fuck they're doing. Level 30, I'll get a hero. They do help.
Perfect.
Allies' town is under siege.
Oh, man. This thing right here is annoying. If you can hear it.
Job's done.
Job's done.
You require my assistance?
You left them personal.
Job's done.
It is hero time. I need to take my leaders, my spot back. See, purple right now is getting fed by somebody who just isn't touching him, so he gets double spawns. I'm gonna get my lead back here. People getting nervous. I know he was gonna leave the game.
Will it be Hatcher?
Job's done.
Oh, I love spelling. And invisible. Well, it is not looking good right now, you guys. Officially lost the game.
Our town is under siege.
Powers come to life. Well, you guys, thanks for watching.